Well, hello to Module 3, and we're going to be talking about managing your time and your social emotional wellness. And we know what time stands for in the Ruma-Time process: thoughts, interactions, mindsets, and emotions. We're going to talk in 3A in this recording. We're going to be talking about definitions, the definitions of self-management skills and relationship management skills, and how those play a role in your social emotional wellness. So let's get started. All right. So manage in the CSS framework means to control, to handle, to address, to treat. Manage is aligned to the self-management skills and is also aligned to relationship management skills. So self-management, what is it? It is the ability, your ability, to use your awareness of your thoughts, interactions, mindsets, and emotions to choose what you say, how you say it, and to do it in order to positively direct your behavior. It's your ability to use what you are now aware of. And remember, awareness, self-awareness included recognize and understand. So now that you are aware, now that you have listed, now that you have dug deeper, now that you have gone to the root of your story and stories, you are now aware. So now that you're aware, what are you going to do and how are you going to manage your thoughts, your interactions, your mindsets, and emotions in what you choose to say, do, think, feel, and believe, and how you can use this newfound ability to manage to positively direct your behaviors. So that's our definition of self-management. Let's go to relationship management. The definition of the relationship management is, again, your ability to recognize, understand, and manage your own emotions and use it to influence others, inspire others, empower others, help equip others. You can't change it and you can't manage it, but you can empower, you could influence, you could inspire, you could motivate, all of those things. When you're able to manage self, then you can help empower others. You can use that new ability to empower others so that you can influence change, and you can also influence the dynamics of relationships. And remember, earlier on, we talked in module 2, we talked about a quote by Dr. Bruce Perry, where he says, healthy relationships basically can change the trajectory. Can change the path of a child who is traumatized or who is struggling. I spoke specifically about that in order to be able to influence and empower and motivate for change, inspire for change, you first have to be able to manage your own self, and you have to be able to care for yourself. You have to be able to recognize and understand your thoughts, your interactions, your mindsets, and your emotions. You cannot. Hear me well. You cannot manage self or others or relationships until and unless you recognize and understand your thoughts, your interactions, your mindsets, and your emotions as they relate to self, others, and situations. So let's go on in the definition for relationship management. It says here, the desired outcome, what you're after as you seek to positively impact, influence, empower relationships, what you're after, what you should be after, is to create bonds with and amongst others so that everyone feels heard, understood, valued, supported, and like they matter. This is key, but you have to first be able to do this with yourself. And so we'll see you in 3B.